Hey, what's up guys, Jeremy here. Let's jump into the bonus example for module 4. Let's get started. The bonus example for module 4 is pretty simple. Let's open a new station, Control N. In the simulation event folder, you will find a fail.sld, a pass.sld, a rdk.sld, and a screen.sld. If you bring that in here, you will find a computer screen. You will find a, I'm gonna hide these and these. You will find a fail mention. You will find a pass mention, and you will find a RDK mention. So I'm gonna hide those RDK mention. So your first job will be pretty simple. You need to bring in those three messages here, right on the screen in the middle. Then you need to recolor them in a way that the RDK is blue, the pass is green, and the fail is red. Then you will create a subprogram, or in fact multiple subprograms, that will kind of jump from one state to the other. So if I show you what I mean by that, file open recent here, I have inspection screen.rdk. Here you have a small subroutine RDK that brings in the RDK message. Here you have a screen pass that brings in the pass message, and screen fail that brings in the fail message. Once you have this done, you can bring it to the pick and scan application, replace the light with the screen, and simply make it show that all inspections are passing the inspection every time we see, we inspect a new bottle. In a future video, later in, I believe, module seven, in fact, we will learn how to do flow control statements. So having an if, so this way we can display either fail or pass at depending on variables that we have internally. But we are not at this point yet, so just show pass every single time you see a new bottle, and then revert back to the RDK screen after a certain time lapse. So you just show RDK for a certain, or in fact you just show pass for a few seconds, and then you revert back to RDK until you come back and you do another scan, and then whoop, it shows pass and then goes back to RDK, and so on and so forth. In the next module, we will learn how to properly import 3D models in RoboDK, how to deal with very heavy objects, how to split objects in multiple pieces, how to use the measurement tool, and how to use the scaling tool. Hope to see you there. In any case, have a great day, guys.